Greetings people from Beer's Blend, my name is Ronald and welcome to another whiskey review. Before we start with today's single malt review, I first of all want to do two things. I first of all want to welcome you all in 2018. I hope you have a good and healthy year. And second of all, I want to give a quick shout out to Whiskey Nederland. He gave me a shout out a couple of weeks ago and I didn't respond because I was busy with all the holiday stuff. If you're Dutch, I highly suggest to check him out. I will leave a link to his channel down in the description. And I have a cat here. I have my one of my kitty cats. Hello, kitty cats. All right, so I'm gonna. I don't know what the cat is gonna do. Probably destroy the whole place. No, those are my whiskey glasses. You can't have those. Those were expensive. Yes, go do cat stuff. My whiskey reviews are going to change a little bit. Oh my god, now it's destroying. My whiskey reviews in 2018 are going to be a bit different. I am going to talk about that after I review and malt mark my whiskey. Talking about malt marks, I forgot them. They are in my drawer. One quick second. I'm gonna kick you. Oh, I'm sorry. Don't yell or scream at me, please. I have no idea what my cat is doing. But malt marks, yes. Can't forget those. Also, I'm looking a little bit like a lobster on camera, I think. But yeah, let's just go with it. A couple weeks ago, I got this. This is, a three... Well, now we have second. You get out. Get out. Go eat food and sleep. Get out. You. I can't review whiskey normally in this house. So yeah, I got this triple pack of some nice whiskies. In this pack we have Talisker 10, Kleinlis 14, and Kleila 12. This wasn't really expensive, like 35, 40 euros. So there also is the same pack with gentle malts. This is called the Classic Malts Coastal Collection. And in the other one we have Dalwhinnie 15, Glenkinchie 12 and Oban 14. So I am thinking about picking it up, but I don't know. We have a whole story written here on the back. We are going to talk about that after we've done the tasting and nose, etc, etc. This is handy because I wanted to try all these three bottles and they're around 30, 40 each. And I saw this and I thought, let's just do this and let's get it over with. But yeah, it's all nice these aren't normal sample bottles. These are like miniature 20 centiliter bottles of the normal bottle. So we have a cork, the normal information, the whole same specs as you would get on a normal bottle. ABV, chill filtration wise, color, etc. So this is the telescope bottle that we are going to review today. And then of course we have Kleinlis in here and Kleila 12 in here. So I haven't opened Kleila 12. I have tried Kleinlis and Talisker. I'm also going to compare Talisker 10 to Springbank 10, because I thought they were kind of similar, but they aren't. And price-wise, they are pretty different, because Talisker 10 is around 30, Springbank is around 40. So I'm gonna get it out of the box. I'm gonna close the box. I'm gonna put it right down here. I also have my empty bottle collection, etc. For the shot. I wanted to spice it up a little bit. Let me know how I can spice up my set here a little bit more. But let's talk about Talisker 10 for a second. It's 45.8%, so I don't think it's chill filtered. I think it is natural color. Does it say anything on the back? No, it doesn't. But I don't think there is color added to it. And if there is, it's not a lot. But this is a mass-produced whiskey of Talisker. Talisker estimated 1830, so it has been around the block quite a while. While I pour this, I'm going to talk a little bit more about it. Talisker, they have a core range, 10-year-old, 18-year-old. They don't have a 15 or 8 or 12-year-old, I believe. Talisker has a lot of non-age-stated whiskies. So, it's interesting, but I would like to see some more age-stated whiskies from Talisker. They have like Dark Storm and all those kind of names, etc. Talisker is an island whiskey, not an isla, but an island whiskey. It's located on the Isle of Skye. I'm just gonna put it there. And it's a nice one. It's around 30, so it's not really in high-end range, but it's a nice dram. I like it a lot. It has that coastal smokiness, little tanginess like you would find in any other coastal malts, but not really peaty. It's not really peaty. It's more on the citrusy, fresh note. It's 10 years old. I can't speak. It's 10 years old, so it's quite young, but it's mature. So I am thinking that Talisker uses good casks. The color is really nice. I like this. You get a whole package for your money. You get a high ABV, you get natural color, non-filled. My god, I'm just gonna sip this and nose it. Yeah, it has some bourbon cask characteristics. I don't think they use sherry casks in this. Lately, I haven't been going to the sherry whiskeys a lot. I have mostly been drinking bourbons and bourbon cask whiskies and some coastal whiskies with a little sherry influence. Last night I tried my Glendronach 12 years old, which is actually 18 years old, and I just didn't like it. I left it on my desk for half an hour, then it turned nice. I also popped the cork on my 18-year-old Allardyce from Glendronach, and that one I really enjoyed. It's thick, it's heavy, it's chocolatey. I'm gonna review that in a couple of weeks, I guess. But let's get back to business. So yeah, the nose is complex, yet it's not really challenging. It's not harsh. I don't get alcohol nose. If you get a little bit further in the glass, then you will get that peatiness. If you want to experiment with some coastal malts, this is a really good one to get. It's not expensive, but it's good quality. And you don't have that medicinal nose. It's bonfire, it's wood, it's ash, but not overwhelming. It's not covering everything up. It's nice. I enjoy the nose. A thick, oily, creamy, covering mouthfeel of the non-chill filtration. It's mouth-watering. It has such a good everything, really. It's all nice. It's complex. You get a little bit of the peatiness, that ashiness. Yet there still is that, like, young and vibrant distillery character from Talisker. This does not taste young in any means and any stretch of the imagination. You don't get that metallic feel. Everything is just nice, cohesing very well together. Not a single thing in this whiskey is overpowering. And as long as the whiskey has that, I'm okay with it. I don't like those really heavy sherry bombs when you only get sherry, or those really peat bombs when you only get peat. Sure, from time to time I enjoy them, but most of the time I drink whiskeys like this, which are just good all around. That's probably why Balvenie Doublewood, 12 years old, became my whiskey of the year of 2017. It's so nice. I heavily suggest picking this up. If you're not a peat fan, you're fine with this. The peat is not dominant. It's cohesing. It adds to the complexity of this whiskey. And for the price, it's a bargain, really. It's a bargain. In some places, I guess, it will go for some more around 40, because well, it's an island whiskey and those tend to have a little bit higher price. But I just love this whiskey in general, and this is for me a perfect daily sipper. But just for the sake of science, let's add some water. I haven't done it to this whiskey, but let's try. Let's just try here. Just a hint of water in the glass. All right. Let's just add a couple drops, really, because we don't have a lot of whiskey in the glass. Just a couple drops, just to open it up a bit, see what we get. Well, we definitely have those bourbon characteristics in here, those nice honey, vanilla, and sweet notes, but not overly sweet or strange sweetiness. It's all cohesing in a whiskey, and I like that. And that's probably why I don't really like my Glendronach 12 normal original, now 18 years old, because the sherry is dominant in that one, and yeah, when you let it sit, then it gets all cohesive, etc., and then I start to enjoy it. Okay, so the bourbon notes on the nose with some water started to, well, get in the back a little bit, and now more of the C notes come forward. So a little bit more of that dryness, saltiness, tanginess, yet still smelling a little bit juicy from the seaweed, I guess. But yeah, it definitely got a little bit drier on the nose with that water. I prefer the nose without water, I think. It changed. In the beginning, I got a nice spiciness, then it mellowed down. I got some, I don't want to say flower notes, but maybe some vegetation. Some coastal vegetation, I guess. Some bushes, etc. And then it turned up, and I got some peatiness, I got some smokiness, I got some fire, some ash, coal maybe even. It's really changing with the water on the palate. Lingering aftertaste. Yeah. There's the smokiness, the tanginess, spiciness. It gets a lot of spice in the finish when you add just a bit of water. I think you can guess what malt mark I'm going to give this. Yeah. And that's just because, well, it deserves it, to be honest. Because it's just a perfect product. Whether I like it or not is irrelevant. These are objective malt marks. Subjective, I'm also going to give it a 10. There we have it. 10 out of 10 for Talisker 10-year-old. I like it a lot. Yes. Price, perfect. Everything is just perfect, in my opinion. It's a really good product, really well crafted. That's why I'm giving it a 10 out of 10. If I go with subjective malt marks, I'm also going to give it a 10 because I like this sort of whiskey. So if you want to know how I feel about it personally, well, there you have it. Well, yeah, let's now talk about the whole thing with Talisker and a little backstory. Well, Talisker has been around quite a while, and well, there once was a poet writer who wrote about Talisker in one of his poets. Then, well, Talisker got a lot of sales, etc. Everything went well until 1960. Then, because of employee not paying attention, the distillery room caught fire, and it was really bad. But yeah, now everything is okay again. But yeah, Talisker is on one of the like more spicy islands in terms of weather. They have really harsh weather on Skye. And the other distillery on Skye is Skepa, I believe. Could be wrong, could be more even. I don't really know. But yeah, Talisker is on the Isle of Skye. So yeah, I am definitely going to try, I think, some other like whiskies from Skye. I think Skepa is from Skye, right? I have to double check. But I really like this. And this is just a perfect product. I will definitely get a bottle of this at some point. I think I will even get the 18-year-old when it is at a good price. Normally, that one goes for around 100, 80 to 100. So, yeah, but you're fine with just this one. This one gets really a good introduction to Talisker. And I think I will try some other Taliskers, maybe with some sherry influence. Because I like my sherry influence, but not dominant. But yeah, paying 30 for this, it's just hard to beat in terms of, yeah, perfection. You don't need to spend a lot of money to have really good whiskey. You just need to know what you're looking for. And that's the whole thing. There are good whiskeys out there. There aren't really bad whiskeys. But you just need to find your wheelhouse, your type of whiskey that you really like. But yeah, let's wrap that one up there, shall we? And now let's talk about the whole channel in 2018. I have a review of Glenfiddich 18-year-old. That one will be coming online next. But yeah, now I'm going to review all of these, I think. But yeah, maybe get a break or something. I don't know. But I want to try to keep my reviews a little shorter, around 15 minutes, like I did with this. Maybe add a story at the end of the video, but yeah, my reviews are most of the time really long, and I want to shorten that up a little bit. I want to get straight into the whiskey, nose it, taste it, tell you all about it, malt market, done. And if people want to continue watching, hear a story of mine or about the distillery or something else, then they can. If they don't, fine. But I think I'm not gonna review a whiskey every single week. I will do a comparison. I promised you all to do a comparison with this and Springbank 10-year-old. I will do that, but in a separate video. So yeah, that's kind of my thing, you know. I want to review a whiskey once every 2 weeks or anything, but I want to still provide you guys with weekly content around whiskey, maybe some information videos, some verses, some blind tastings, that kind of stuff, you know? Because there's a lot of whiskey that well works with some other things, you know? Maybe do more verses, or maybe food pairings or something, I don't know. Whiskey and chocolate is always nice. But yeah, I think I'm gonna head off here. Let me know what you think about Talisker 10-year-old, if you have it or not, what's your opinion about it. I highly suggest every whiskey lover should pick this one up, because it's just a good product. It's just nice, it's well-rounded, and it's a really good bang for your buck. So yeah, don't forget to check out Whiskey Nederland. Thanks for the shout out, Martijn. I really appreciate it a lot. So yeah, I'm gonna head off. 10 out of 10. We're going to start the year off with a big one. So I thank you for watching, and well, I see you later. Goodbye.